Hi, I'm Dr. Gupta. Another common question asked by my patients is concerning reflux, or GERD, Gastro Esophageal Reflux Disease. GERD is essentially when stomach contents, whether it be solid or liquid, are pushed into the esophagus. And that causes a symptom of heartburns, regurgitation, and just discomfort. Now, how does GERD happen? What is the reason why one experiences GERD? Usually the food goes through your mouth into your food pipe and passes into the stomach. At the junction of the food pipe and the stomach is a band of fibers called lower esophageal sphincter, which makes it like a one-way passage. So food can enter into the stomach, but should not be coming back up. When this sphincter is loose or incompetent, food can easily regurgitate into your food pipe, causing inflammation, ulceration, nausea, food coming into your mouth. Some people complain of sore throat, difficulty in breathing and cough, especially when they lie down. So these are the typical symptoms of gastroesophageal reflux disease. Now, what besides this can cause GERD? There are various medicines for asthma, blood pressure, and even narcotics and sedatives, which can decrease the tonicity or the strength of the lower esophageal sphincter and cause these symptoms. Diagnosis usually is made by upper endoscopy, where a flexible tube with a light at the end goes into your mouth, into your food pipe and stomach, take pictures and biopsies and examine exactly what is going on, whether there's any damage to the esophagus or not, and biopsies can be taken to prove if there's any changes in the lining of the esophagus, and that can very safely and very effectively diagnose the condition of GERD. There are other things which you should be aware of. GERD can cause inflammation, ulceration, and also sometimes changes in the lining of the esophagus, which is called Barrett's esophagus. Now, this is a pre-malignant condition, and one has to be screened reasonably frequently if you have that. So about close to 10% of people who have GERD will have Barrett's, and almost 10% of people with Barrett's will have some sort of a cancer in the esophagus. So almost close to 1% of people who have regular heartburn or GERD can end up with having problems in the esophagus. So get your testing done if you really think you have these symptoms. Another test that can be easily done is a barium swallow, which is very good, but will not be able to biopsy the esophagus to look for any changes like Barrett's. What are the other modifications which I prescribe my patients? Typically, patients who have GERD, I advise them to lose weight. Don't wear tight clothing. There should be nothing tight around their abdominal girth. Avoid coffee, chocolate, peppermint, alcohol. Avoid spicy foods. Don't lie down immediately after a big meal. If possible, eat 3 to 4 hours before you lie down, and elevate the head end of your bed by about 6 inches. With this behavior modification and the various medicines that we have available, like antacids, H2 blockers like Zantac, or proton pump inhibitors like Prilosec, Asfex, Dexalant, Pantoprazole, and Nexium, they can help decrease the acid in your stomach, so there is no acid refluxing into your food pipe and causing these symptoms. So if you have any of these symptoms, like night cough, clearing of the throat all the time, sore throat, chest pains, heartburns, and you feel food regurgitating up into your mouth, consult a gastroenterologist and be tested adequately and be treated then. Thank you.